let's talk about butterflies. You will notice that butterflies have four wings, a head with antenna on it, and an abdomen, which is their bodies. The top wing is the forewing, and the bottom wing is the hind wing. They have three parts of their bodies, which is a head, and then a thorax in the middle, and the abdomen at the bottom. Butterflies come in all different colors with all different designs on them, and I want you to take a look at them as we go through these photographs. This one just has black and red. This one here is a very fuzzy body with tiger stripes and red dots. Take a look at how complex that is. Here's a two-tailed pasha. You can see the two tails on the back and almost like a maze on the front of its wings with ending in spots and stripes at the back. Here's a tiger swallowtail. Also, the body is pretty hairy, but look at the tiger stripes and then the blue and red at the bottom wings. Just how beautiful and magnificent those are. And a whole worksheet filled with different types of butterflies that you might want to look back on as you design your own butterfly today. This has several different species of butterflies right here. All right, so the difference between a butterfly and a moth, you can see they're very, very similar. But one of the big differences is that a butterfly has a proboscis, which is the mouth, and then the moth doesn't have a proboscis. They tend to have a mouth or no mouth. Sometimes they do have a proboscis, but you can see how the moth has very fuzzy antennas, which is very different from your butterfly. Moths also tend to come out at night, not always, but tend to, whereas butterflies tend to only come out in the day. Butterflies and moths' reproduction are pretty similar to each other in that they lay eggs, which hatch baby caterpillar, and those generally eat plants in order to grow. Here's that same caterpillar that has gotten older and changed color and now grown into a pupa and then finally emerged from the pupa as a large emperor moth. That male emperor moth will then meet a female emperor moth and then start the whole cycle over again. And you'll notice with these beautiful emperor moths that the male is actually the small one and the female is the large one. And they also have big eye-shaped patterns on their wings. So think about different kinds of patterns as you look at these. Now here's an oleander hawk moth caterpillar. I was curious if you can tell what a moth will look like based on what the caterpillar looks like. So here it is as an adult, and it is indeed green with a very interesting, neat pattern on it. Here's a Jersey tiger caterpillar, and it has orange stripes against a black and white spotted spine, and you can see what it looks like as an adult. The Jersey tiger moth has kind of a zebra pattern with orange bottom wings. Are you getting some good ideas for your moth or butterfly? All right, let's talk antenna. So these are different types of antennas that you would find on a butterfly or a moth. Some of them are definitely more moth-like. So antenna A is very smooth and it looks kind of like a Q-tip on the end that you use to clean your ears. B has more of a hook on the end of it. C is almost like a worm, the way it's long and thick with a tiny hook at the end. D is very, very thin, like what you might expect to see from a different type of an insect, like a beetle. And then E is like a feather. That is very much typical for what you would see for moth antennas. And I have a few very cute pictures of moths with their giant feathery antennas for you to take a look at. Let's see. Here you can see his compound eyes with those long, wispy, feathery antennas. And this cute little guy looks like a bat to me with his giant feathery antennas. This one is called a heart moth, and you might be able to tell why. Do you see the hearts on there? Very cool. This one is found in England and it's very plain but very fuzzy. Here are two more moths that are very, very colorful with so much pattern on them. I want you to really look at that pattern. Do you see how they're grasping a hold of that stem? Those antennas? Here's another beautiful moth with striped antennas. You can do stripes on your antennas. It's otherwise pretty simple except for the color. And another one with more dots and eyes and yellow tips on the antenna and very kind of furry looking on its body. So think about that. And a Camberwell Beauty This has the deep color and then that bright blue that you see in dots all the way around the edges. And that's the same butterfly, the underside of the wing, called the underwing. So you can see the difference if it wants to show off or if it's trying to hide. So there you can see a 5-spot burnet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you count those 5 red spots? Those big antennas, also beautiful. This guy is trying to pretend to be a bug, like a bee or something. He looks kind of menacing, so it doesn't even look much like a butterfly. And here's a hummingbird moth. We have these in Texas, but they look just like hummingbirds, and they come out in the evenings to feed on flowers, and they fly just like a hummingbird. They are amazing. Now let's take a look at what we're gonna do for our project. To start with our butterfly project, you're gonna need a piece of white cardstock and a picture of some butterflies and scissors and a pencil. You're gonna take your cardstock and you're gonna fold it in half. Butterflies are symmetrical, which means they're the same on both sides. So if we draw half a butterfly on this paper and cut it out, when we open it up, it will be a full butterfly. So make sure this folded edge is where the center of your butterfly, the body is gonna be. Take a look at some pictures of butterflies and draw half of it. So if I choose the swallowtail, I only need half of it and I just need the shape. I don't need to add all the details to it, just the shape. So just half. And if I were to divide this butterfly in half, I'm just gonna use the right hand side, and half of it falls right in the center of its body. So on your paper, you are going to start with the body, half of it, and that's what it is. And then wings. The top wing comes out right below the head, so about here, and it goes in and out, and it comes back right about where it starts to come out right here. So I know I have these little guides to draw my wing if I want it to look like a swallowtail. I can make it however you want, but to draw a nice big wing and have it come back. Next one, the wing, this bottom wing does come out of the body, but it you can't really see it very well because this continues. So we are going to go ahead and let this one come out similarly. It doesn't attach down at the bottom of this body. It still attaches up here on the thorax. So we're gonna have it attach there on our drawing. And draw something swallowtail like that. All right, so now that I have my shape for my butterfly or moth or whatever it is that you want to do, I want it to go a little bit higher. As soon as you have the shape that you are happy with, make sure that it is on that folded edge, so you'll have an entire butterfly, and grab scissors and cut around the outline. This is going to be your template. Okay, and let's open it up, and boom, I have a beautiful butterfly. And you can do the same thing for a moth. You can do the same thing for anything that you want. So then your next step is to grab your black cardstock and your pencil and a silver Sharpie. And you're gonna decide where you want your butterfly. Do you want it in the center? Do you want it flying off at an angle, if it'll fit? How do you want your butterfly to be displayed? I'm gonna go ahead and do it this way. put mine dead center. All right, with your pencil, now that you have a perfectly symmetrical butterfly, you are going to outline it. You can use a white pencil or a regular pencil and outline it. If you have trouble with this, you might have someone else hold it for you while you try to go around it. You can also put a little bit of sticky tape on the back to make sure it doesn't wiggle on you if you're by yourself and doing this. Otherwise, you just have to really hold it down and be prepared to erase should anything shift around on you. It takes a minute to get it to work. All right, now do you see that butterfly on there? Now it is time to add details. So I'm going to draw the body of my butterfly in here. I'm gonna draw antennas. I remember there's so many different ways of doing that. And then start with your pattern. And you can look at an actual existing butterfly if you'd like, or you can simply wing it, ha ha ha, wing it. But you want your pattern to be the same on both sides. So if I have a big area like this on the left, I need to immediately come over here and do the same thing on the right. And continue to do the whole butterfly that way. And once you have your butterfly as complicated as you want it, then grab your silver Sharpie marker and outline what you've done. Now, once you have your basic outline of everything done, you need to add texture. And that includes interesting, almost like color changes. And on the body, that could be fur. Remember, some of those butterflies and moths were pretty furry, fuzzy looking. So go ahead, if you'd like, and add little bits of little lines that suggest possibly some hairs in here. All right, so it doesn't look quite so cartoonish. And add some other textures and things in here. Dots work very nicely. Make sure it's symmetrical on both sides. Or if you put dots on one, you need to make sure you put dots on the other. And continue. Now, when you feel like you have enough pattern on your butterfly,
You can go ahead and add possibly a leg or something to make it look a little bit more realistic. If you don't want to, that is fine as well. Sometimes it helps make it feel a little bit more real. And that is totally up to you if you would like to do that. So here are other examples where I did add legs to this one. I add more interesting and right here with this one as well. So you can have fun doing it however you'd like. And that's it.